So let's dive into the latest royal drama that's buzzing in the news. Picture this. Harry and Meghan, along with Omid Scobie, are at the center of a whirlwind of controversy. And let me tell you, this new book, Endgame by Scobie, it's stirring up a storm. The big question on everyone's lips is, where do Harry and Meghan stand in all this? If they don't come forward and distance themselves from the negativity in Scobie's book, it's almost like they're giving it a thumbs up, right? Here's the scoop. Buckingham Palace has been super classy, keeping quiet about the bombshells dropped in Endgame. Honestly, it's like watching a high-stakes game of chess where the palace is playing it cool. Why? Because acknowledging this book would be like stepping into a quicksand of drama, especially with the ongoing saga of Harry and Meghan. Now, here's a juicy bit. The Dutch version of the book might have accidentally spilled the beans on the identity of the royal who allegedly made a comment about baby Archie's skin color. Talk about a plot twist. But let's not forget the Duke and Duchess here. Their silence. It's almost as if they're saying, yep, Scobie is our guy. By not clarifying their relationship with him, they're indirectly fueling the fire of speculation. Scobie's book is a cocktail of allegations, like the claim that the Princess of Wales was the Queen's favorite because of her pliant nature, even dubbing her Katie Keene. That's a new one for Catherine, who, before marrying William, was tagged with the not-so-nice label Weighty Katie. So there you have it. The royal roller coaster continues. Stay tuned to see how this unfolds. Moving on to the next part of this royal roller coaster, let's talk about Catherine, the Princess of Wales. The book paints her as someone who's had a smoother ride compared to Meghan, suggesting that she's a part-time royal because she likes to hang out with her kids during school holidays. And then there's this portrayal of her as someone who only shows up for smiley photo ops. But hey, let's be real. Isn't that what we see Meghan doing a lot these days too? Smiling for the cameras, often in the company of A-listers or those she hopes to be in that circle with. Now, let's not lose focus on the main issue here. Harry and Meghan need to make their stance clear about Scobie's book. If they don't openly reject it, it's like they're giving it their seal of approval. Why would they want to be linked to such controversy? Maybe it's because their previous attempts to tell their story, the Oprah interview, the Netflix series, Harry's memoir, Spare, haven't quite convinced everyone. Is Scobie's book their last-ditch effort to control the narrative in this so-called War of the Windsors? But here's the kicker. The royal family seems to be doing just fine without them. Imagine a world where Harry and Meghan had stayed as working royals. They could have made a real impact. However, their departure, along with all the drama they stirred up, hasn't brought down the monarchy. In fact, it appears to have only made it stronger. Despite the challenges, including what could be considered one of the most tumultuous periods for the royals, they seem to be holding their ground pretty well. Now, let's switch gears and look at how the royal family has been handling things, especially after the sad passing of Queen Elizabeth. It's been a tough period, but instead of creating a fuss, the royals have been quietly going about their charitable work, seemingly growing stronger together in the face of adversity. There's an interesting dynamic unfolding between King Charles and Prince William. They haven't always seen eye to eye, but lately, they seem more united than ever. This newfound alignment could be a result of them both being targets of Prince Harry's criticism, along with their wives. If Prince William ever felt torn between his brother and his father, Harry's actions, particularly his harsh words about Queen Camilla and Catherine, seem to have clarified things for him. It's like Harry has unwittingly played a role in strengthening the bond between Charles and William. This situation has also seemingly brought Camilla and Catherine closer. There's a noticeable warmth in their relationship now. You could really see it during the Remembrance Sunday service at the Cenotaph. They both play pivotal roles in supporting their husbands and seem to understand and embrace their responsibilities with grace and dignity. But amidst all this, the ongoing jabs from Team Sussex, either directly or through proxies like Scobie, just keep coming. It's been almost 4 years since Harry and Meghan stepped back, asking for privacy while paradoxically intruding into the private lives of their family members. It's a bit baffling, isn't it? Despite the time that has passed, this saga shows no signs of slowing down. The irony of demanding privacy while publicly airing family matters is hard to miss. As we continue to unravel this tale, it's worth asking, why are Meghan and Harry still so fixated on the past? They've got the freedom and independence they wanted, but they seem unable to let go. Their departure from the royal family was marked by a flurry of drama and a lack of self-awareness, and it seems like they believed the monarchy would crumble without their stardust. But here's the twist. The royal family hasn't just survived their departure. It appears to be thriving. King Charles has stepped into his role with dignity, disproving skeptics alongside Camilla, who has shown herself to be dedicated and hardworking. William and Catherine are acing their royal duties, and even less prominent members like Sophie, the Duchess of Edinburgh, are stepping up. The monarchy, far from collapsing post-Harry and Meghan, seems revitalized. This unexpected turn of events must be a tough pill for the Sussexes to swallow. They probably envisioned a royal family in disarray after their exit, but the opposite has happened, and this might be fueling the seemingly desperate attempts at character assassination in Scobie's book. Are Harry and Meghan trying to stay in the limelight? It seems likely, but the world has largely moved on. The real tragedy here is that this book, and the Sussexes' apparent endorsement of it, is backfiring. It paints them in a rather unflattering light, bitter, petty, and jealous of those who continue to uphold their duties with dedication. What's more, the longer they remain silent on Scobie's claims, the more they're perceived as complicit in these attacks. This silence is not just damaging their public image, it's digging them deeper into a narrative of negativity and resentment. Diving deeper into this royal saga, one can't help but wonder about the widening rift between Prince Harry and the rest of the royal family. With every passing day and every silent endorsement of these contentious narratives, the chances of mending fences seem to diminish. It's a situation that raises many questions about reconciliation and the future dynamics within the royal family. Now, I'm curious to hear your thoughts on all this. What's your take on the situation? Do you think there's a path to peace for Harry and the royal family, or has this ship sailed? Your opinions are valuable, so feel free to share your thoughts. That wraps up our dive into this royal drama for now. It's a story that keeps on giving, and we'll surely have more updates in the future. Thanks for joining in on this discussion, and remember, the royal saga continues, so stay tuned for more insights and updates.